Hello everyone, I'm Zach and welcome back to another Hit Film Tutorial. Keeping with this month's Halloween theme, we'll be looking at how to turn yourself into the Headless Horseman using Hit Film in Blender. We're currently running a Halloween short film competition with lots of great prizes. The due date is October 24th, so you still have some time to enter. Click the card on screen for more info. Along with this competition, we also launched a Discord channel, where you can talk to other Hit Film users, get feedback on your projects, and join our growing community of talented filmmakers and content creators. A link to join the Discord can be found in the video description. See ya there! We filmed our footage in front of a green screen so we could swap out the background for a digital environment. A practical orange light was used to represent the flickering light of the fire, and other lighting was used to match the moonlit environment. Tracking markers were placed throughout the scene so we could track the camera movement. We also placed tracking markers on Tom's face to help track the 3D model pumpkin in Blender, but you could manually animate the 3D model instead of tracking it. If you are new to Blender, I'd recommend checking out our Blender to Hit Film masterclass. Because the camera is moving in our shot, we first have to do a 3D camera track. I tracked the camera in Blender, but you could also use the Foundry Camera Tracker in HitFilm Pro and export the camera to Blender as an FBX file. You can find our detailed tutorial on Foundry's camera tracker linked in the card on screen, as well as a Blender camera tracking tutorial linked in the description. We need to track the motion of the actor's head so the pumpkin moves correctly. The track doesn't have to be perfectly accurate as the original head will be removed, and the pumpkin will appear to be floating. For the final shot, I did a Blender object track for the last half of the shot where the tracking worked well. I then applied that tracking data to a 3D object. I'd recommend this free head model from blendswap.com. The track went a little wonky towards the beginning where there wasn't enough tracking data, so I converted the track into keyframe animation and deleted those bad keyframes. I then manually animated the head model for the rest of the shot. If you're interested in a more detailed look at head tracking in Blender, be sure to check out our Justice League Cyborg tutorial linked in the card on screen. It is now time to replace our actor's head with a jack-o'-lantern. This 3D model is free to download from sketchfab.com, link in the description. Import the GLTF 3D model into Blender. The file comes in with a hierarchy of empty objects parented to one another. So to make things simpler, I'll delete all those objects, leaving just the pumpkin and stem. I'll also join those two objects into one. Enable Material Preview to see the textures on the model. Place this pumpkin model so it lines up with the tracked head model. Then parent it to the head. I chose to make the model higher resolution by adding a subdivision surface modifier. The details on the pumpkin's face appear to be sticking out instead of in, so go over to the Shading tab. Add an RGB Curves node before the Normal Map node. Then invert the green channel by adjusting the curve. Now the Normal Map detail renders correctly. I also want the jack-o'-lantern's face to glow very brightly, so I'll increase the material's emission strength. We now need to match the lighting of our 3D scene to the lighting of our video footage. Enable Scene Lights and Scene World to see our own lighting instead of the defaults. Also enable Transparent in the Film Settings, then go to Rendered View. For this project, I rendered using the EV Render Engine so we can preview the render in real time. I'll start by adding area lights and adjusting their position, rotation, color, power, and size to match the lights we filmed with on set. To add some additional lighting and reflections, we can use an HDRI. I downloaded an HDRI from polyhaven.com that generally matched the digital environment created in Unreal Engine. In the World properties, select that HDRI as the environment texture. Then in the Shading tab, adjust the strength value to control the brightness. For the final render, make sure to enable motion blur. Render a test image by going to Render, Render Image, and make sure everything looks good and that no other objects are visible in the render. Create a folder for the image sequence, then render the animation as an RGBA PNG sequence. It is now time to turn our actor into the Headless Horseman by replacing their head with the pumpkin we rendered out of Blender. Import the rendered image sequence into HitFilm, then drag it into a composite shot above your actor layer. We can still see some of our actor's head appearing behind the pumpkin, so I'll draw a freehand mask around Tom's head. Since I already have a mask on this layer, I can set this new mask to subtract so it cuts out of the footage. Make sure to enable keyframing for the mask path, then go through the whole shot, animating the mask to continue cutting off your actor's head. You may want to switch between multiple masks if the shape changes a lot throughout the shot. Now it looks like the pumpkin has replaced Tom's head. Depending on your camera angle and your actor's costume, you may still see the actor's neck like we do here. If that is the case, you'll first have to rotoscope that area. I used Mocha HitFilm to speed up the roto process, and you can learn more about rotoscoping with Mocha in the tutorial linked in the card on screen. A quick and easy way to hide your actor's neck is to use that rotoscope mask on a black plane. Instead of making the plane pure black, try sampling a dark color from your video, then add a grain effect to match the noise in your footage. If you're interested in a more detailed removal, check out our invisibility tutorial and our headless ghost tutorial linked in the description. Let's set this jack-o'-lantern on fire using HitFilm's particle simulator. The fire should stick to the pumpkin, so we first need to export our 3D animation out of Blender. You'll need to install the Blender to HitFilm exporter script linked in the video description. Select the animated head model and export it to a HitFilm composite shot. Then select the pumpkin, go to the last frame in the shot, and export it as an OBJ file. Back in HitFilm, import the composite shot from Blender. This will bring in the animated camera and a 3D point representing the animated head. Then import the OBJ model. Uncheck Center Anchor Point and Auto Normalize Scale, then hit OK. Open the model layer's properties, go to the last frame, and parent the pumpkin model to the animated point layer. We now have our pumpkin head animation in HitFilm. Drag a new particle simulator onto the timeline. Attach the emitter to the 3D point layer, then adjust its position to place it over one of the eyes. Set the trajectory to cone, then adjust the rotation so the particles fly outwards from the face. Add a new force and adjust its rotation and strength to make the particles move upwards. Choose one of the fire textures for the appearance and set the blend mode to add. In the lifetime panel, set the alpha to gradient, then add points on the gradient to make the particles fade in and out. Reduce the life, scale, and speed of the particles. Then add some variation. Increase the particles per second to fill out the effect. Also add some variation to the texture angle. When you are happy with this emitter, duplicate it and move it to the other eye. Then change the seed on the particle system so it isn't an exact copy. To make the particles be properly occluded by the pumpkin, set the particle's depth source layer to the 3D model. Be sure to enable motion blur for this layer as well. We can enhance this particle sim and make it look more realistic by applying some additional effects. To give the fire a more fluid-like motion, I applied some heat distortion effects. One effect added some large distortion, and the other one added some smaller details. To make these particles look like fire, add a color vibrance effect and use the flames preset. You can also tweak the brightness and color with additional color correction effects. To better blend the fire with the rest of the shot, set the layer's blend mode to add. The glowing face of the jack-o'-lantern is too dark compared to the fire, so let's brighten it up with a super glow effect. Adjust the threshold so only the bright face is glowing. Then give it an orange tint to match the fire. We now have our actor's head removed and replaced with the flaming jack-o'-lantern. Let's look at how to tie everything together and create a more moody and spooky atmosphere. We can totally change the mood of this shot with some color grading. I used a curves effect to darken the whole image, which makes a big difference already. I then took some red out of the shadows, and added more blue and a little more green. This color adjustment makes the shot look more like nighttime instead of day. A hue saturation effect was applied to lower the overall saturation, as well as reduce the saturation of the reds even more to help the fire fit into the scene better. Finally, various lens effects were applied to tie everything together and make the shot seem like it was filmed with a real camera. And that's how you can create your own Headless Horseman VFX. Be sure to check out our other Halloween-themed tutorials and to submit your entry to our Halloween competition by October 24th. Join our Discord to chat with us in the community, get feedback on your projects, and more. Leave a comment and hit the like button if you learned something new. Remember to subscribe for more tutorials like this. See you next time!